Stan, are you 35? Are you 35, Stan?
Yeah, I had really? A great birthday alone. No, yeah, I
35, man. Yeah,
it's amazing. Late, huh?
No, you look younger. What are you using? What's your secret potion?
Oof, you don't want to know. It's not vegan.
Let me guess. It's
not vegan.
Let me guess. French wine.
French wine, more Italian wine.
Ah, more Italian. You like Italian wine?
Yes.
Ooh. More romantic soul right there. What I said after the finals last year against Roger in Wimbledon, which was, you know, one of the most epic matches that I was part of. And there it was really interesting, you know, in terms of the crowd support and everything, with most of the people were cheering for him. And I mean, that was obvious from on and off the court as well. But Why do I think it's still like that?
Yeah.
Well, look, you know, I mean, we can discuss about various things and factors why this is in such way or other way. It's really hard to say. I mean, for sure, one thing is that Roger is, you know, arguably the greatest player of all time. He's the guy that is liked around the world. So I don't expect, to be honest, in most of the cases, as long as he's playing, the crowd to be in majority on my side, if you know what I mean. Yes, some places maybe, but in most of the places they're going to support Roger, and I'm okay with that because this is, it's Roger. So, and it's very similar situation with Rafa. So yeah, it's hard for me to answer to that question. Why is it like that? Am I contributing to that in a negative way, that I'm taking away the crowd support for me? I don't think so. I think it's more just the greatness of Roger Federer and Rafael Nadal, and not them just as a tennis players, but them as people, as very charismatic, you know, nice guys, humble guys, great champions, that have, you know, made huge mark in our sport. And I am part of their era. So in one way, I'm lucky. In another way, maybe not so much.
Match you lost and you were the most angry going out?
Well, one of them was with you, Roland Garros finals in 15.
But why you were hungry?
Another one was probably also with you in 15. Was it 16 in New York? I don't know. For some reason, you make me angry, man.
Oh, come on.
You completely dismantled my game.
You guys can live a little bit for the other, so please.
No,
I've been 15 years on the tour, and I got only few, so please let me that.
No, but I just.
But
I just,
why you get angry? Because you think you played bad? You think you
no,
missed
because,
the opportunity to get, or just because you lost?
Exactly. Well, not. Look. Both of the matches that I lost to you in finals was at Roland Garros and US Open. I felt that it was a very similar trajectory of the match.
Yeah.
I started well, I won first set in both of the matches, and then some close games, pretty even in the second set, where result was kind of here and there, didn't lose my chances, and that's where you pick up. And then you go to a level which was higher than mine, and you were a better player and you won against me. So I was not upset with the way I've played, because if you just overplay me, if you're just better, that's it. I cannot be too upset because of that. I just have to accept it and say well done. But I was upset with myself that I repeat the same thing twice, that I allowed you to take the momentum and the control of the match. And I feel like I had an opportunities in both second set of both finals to just you know, win the second set, and then probably the match, or there would be a much higher chance for me to win with being two sets up. So this, I was upset with this kind of output.